The built environment is how we shape our world. It's how we shape our reality. A PhD in the built environment affords our candidates an opportunity to explore architecture and even some of the technologies that govern the way we design. My name's Dr. Nilesh Bakshi. I'm the postgraduate research and industry liaison leader here at the Tearo campus and the School of Architecture. So what happens at the end of a PhD? That's a fantastic question to be thinking about even before you consider coming to Victoria University for a PhD. We've got candidates around the world who are now industry leaders. We've got people who are working in government. We've got people who are working in councils. We've got graduates of our PhD program who are here. In fact, I myself was a PhD candidate in the same building a few years ago. So academia is absolutely an avenue, but because you're doing a PhD in the built environment, what you're actually doing is affecting change in industry, which doesn't restrict you to just an academic career. A common misconception about a PhD in the built environment is that it's restricted to just the built environment. We have PhD candidates currently exploring human behavior and how we can explore human comfort. We have PhD candidates who are exploring ideas of AI and how we can begin to use newer technologies to influence the way in which we design. We have PhD candidates who are also exploring ideas about how you can automate not just design, but the way in which we can create entire cities. What that means is our PhD program affords us an opportunity to delve into the way in which the built environment can truly be evolved. I think a PhD in the built environment changes the way we view that built environment. It helps our candidates to really critique and scrutinize the way in which we as a society, we as an industry, currently practice. But actually, it's not just about practice, it's about innovating research. So a PhD has the potential to change the way you even view literature. And that is the most exciting part of a PhD in the built environment. It spans a wide array of things that we implore our students to discover. One of the key architectural challenges that we're facing as a society today is how can we combat climate change? What we know already is the built environment is responsible for a substantial impact. Upwards of 40% of our global emissions can be attributed to our built environment. What that means is our PhD students have a relatively difficult challenge to meet, and we implore our students to fill whatever gap of knowledge they can find that will help us address this very difficult future. A PhD degree is 3 years. Within those 3 years, your first year is all about creating your research proposal. With the support of two supervisors, you will spend your first year, your provisional year, creating a research plan, a research proposal that identifies how you're going to fill a gap of knowledge, what that gap of knowledge is, and what are the methodologies you need to adopt to conduct your study. In the following 2 years, you set off on the road to fill said gap of knowledge, to then actually do the hardest part of a PhD, which is the work. After moving from provisional to full registration, our PhD candidates begin their research journey. They will, depending on their topics, lay out a publication plan, lay out a strategy for how they're going to fill their gap of knowledge, and essentially begin to prepare for their viva voce, which is to present your key findings of your research with living voice. The School of Architecture at Victoria University of Wellington is embedded in our urban landscape. We are working in the heart of the very type of city we are trying to understand. At this, the heart of New Zealand's capital affords our candidates an opportunity to understand the built environment in ways you cannot in any other city in New Zealand. Unlike other parts of the world, unlike even some of the universities we have in New Zealand, Victoria University of Wellington is deeply embedded in our city, it's deeply embedded in our practice, and it's deeply embedded in design. If you're interested in exploring a PhD in the built environment, we very much look forward to welcoming you here in the heart of the city at Victoria University of Wellington.